There is a problem with objective personality, and that problem is sample size. Okay, so objective personality has come up with a pretty good way of typing people. What they do is, and I really respect them for this, is they work together in different rooms to come at and find the right type for another person. They work together, they discuss with each other in order to find what type a person is. The mistake that they are doing is they are choosing their own sample, choosing their own bias, and in doing so, choosing their own conclusions. If you are curious about this, leave a like and subscribe and enjoy the rest of the video. Okay, so what does it mean to choose your own sample? It means that you select who you type and you select the coins or methods by which you type that person. You discuss together in a group how to type that person and through which means to decide on the type of that person. What's wrong with this? The problem is choosing your own bias. Yeah, what objective personality type has done, what they've come to do is they've come to select and choose a certain amount of cues, definitely visual cues, that they keep rehearsing over and over. In practice, anyone with red hair ends up belonging to a certain type group or type modal. In fact, everyone with a proclivity to have a more feminine appearance is going to be typed in a certain way. Yeah, they end up typing people based on unconscious patterns that they learn to recognize in between each other's. They have no idea how to interpret their coins and how to use them and how to apply them to understand what people are saying. They get to choose how they decide to apply these coins and they get to choose what they look for. So they get lost. They get lost in their own bias. They get lost in their own subjective way of thinking about and approaching type. They come up with their own definitions, their own scales. They've ended up throwing the entire Jungian theory out of the window. There is no reference anymore to Carl Jung or the cognitive functions. There are no theoretical establishments to explain what objective personality is seeing. There are no connections to any form of scientific model. Not even the Big Five. Objective personality has had to get rid of everything to fit and to continue to practice their own bias. They are staying determined, staying on course, trying to repeat and rehearse their own patterns and their own methodology. They've developed a kind of precision, but they have not developed accuracy. Precision is learning to consistently hit the same place over and over again. Accuracy is actually learning to hit the bullseye. Yeah, objective personality are able to consistently hit the same place over and over again, but have they attained accuracy? One way I'm seeing this is by looking at the people typed by objective personality's own model. In fact, most of them don't have the type that they think they do. Most people are, in objective personality's own terms, mistyped. You cannot see yourself. Only we can see you. We can see your patterns, but you cannot see yourself. If you cannot see yourself, if you cannot learn to see yourself, if you cannot learn to see the patterns by which objective personality has typed you, their system is useless. It has no applied value for the individual being typed. If this person can actually learn to see these patterns for themselves, can learn to recognize these cues and the personality traits that they're supposed to have, then there is a value for the person in understanding themselves and understanding their personality. But if they can't do this, there is no point to anything. So, objective personality should include a third person in their model of typing, the person they are actually studying. They should be linking and connecting what they do to the Big Five. They should be tracing every time a person is typed what that person's Big Five is. They should be linking and connecting what they are saying back to the original Jungian definitions and seeing if there is a connection. They should be talking to the person they are typing and they should be testing and checking if the things they are seeing are really there. They should be, every time they come up with a new coin, testing it with the group of people that they have typed, running studies, asking questions, figuring out if these coins exist. But they're not doing that really. that information is not really there. They are choosing themselves how they interpret your behavior and what connections they have found in your actions, but they are not asking you what patterns you think that you have or how you think you are doing things or why you're doing things that way. They don't trust you. They only trust themselves. But how can they really trust that they're not biased? That's my question for today. Let me know in the comments down below what your thoughts are on the matter, and I hope to see you all in the next video.